It's pretty here. Just like Moscow.
Better, actually. More futuristic. And on a larger scale. My design.
Your what?
A linguistic error. I meant to say that it embodies my favorite design.
Come on, not that
hard. So, what will it be, Major? Weapon?
Here's Lenin, just like at the VDH in Moscow.
Indeed. But this statue was erected not by simple workmen, but by robots, based on a sculptor's sketches. This...
Locked. What else is new? Charles, open it.
Unfortunately, I...
Lack the ability to unlock doors. You're like a broken record, you know that? I'll deal with it. On. Sweet. Oh yeah. There's a Hawkins guy. Okay, what do we have here?
Are you planning to disable the Hawk? It isn't responsible for opening the VDNH's doors, you know.
Well, I gotta do something, okay? I'll start with the Hawk. It's the Hawk's service button. What does it do?
It will cause the Hawk to land, so it can be serviced by a technician.
How long will it stay there for?
If it fails to make contact with a technician, not long.
Then we need to move.
What are you planning?
I'm gonna take a ride on the Hawk and get a better view of the place. Maybe I'll see something. What are these cables for? They weren't here before.
The cables stabilize the Hawk during bad weather.
Maybe I can slide down a cable.
Interesting fact. From a bird's eye view, you can see that the grass in the park was planted in the shape of the peaceful atom.
A bird's eye view? That, it's that thing again.
Be careful. Hawk 7 units are quite dangerous.
Oh, come on. It's freaking adorable.
Mm.
thing? A civilian robot?
You tell me, Major. You have far more experience with combat robots than I do.
I do? I mean, shit, I do, but I can't remember a damn thing. They seem different somehow. Pretty impressive, isn't it? You can really tell we're on the threshold of something really incredible. I just wish there weren't bodies all over the damn place.
The celebration will be held on Monday in honor of national polymerization and the launch of Collective 2.0. All the highest ranking members of the Communist Party will be here.
I can fix all this by then.
I certainly hope your optimism turns out to be justified.
It will, you'll see. I won't let Dr. Sechenov down again. More locked doors. Who the hell keeps locking everything? Whoever he is. I bet he's... The mirror on the left isn't working.
Something is jamming the mechanism and preventing the mirror from ascending.
Got it. Looks like it's back to the basement for me. No entry. And a skull and crossbones. That's encouraging. Where am I?
The magnetic shock absorption system is located on this basement level. All the rooms here are full of mobile electromagnetic clusters.
I can use an EMP on them. It's not gonna kill me, is it?
Let's hope not, Comrade Major.
What? So I could get crushed by a falling wall of magnets?
Theoretically speaking, that shouldn't happen, but this is merely a hypothesis. I've never been here before.
Seriously? That's weird. Well, whatever.
Comrade Major, have you made it to the VDNH?
Kinda.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means I'm kinda almost there. I'm in the magnetic shock absorption chamber, looking for a way to unlock the entrance doors. Can you open them for me?
No, I can't. I don't have the skills. This is your responsibility.
Then get off my grill. Those freaks and their goddamn mustaches again. What's the point of this fucking maze anyway?
The magnetic shock absorption system was developed by scientists from Kiev Polytechnic University. It's a very complex and comprehensive device that alters its configuration according to the situation.
So it's plan B in case of a natural disaster.
Among other things. But it is first and foremost a trial run of the magnetic shock absorption system. Here, under Earth conditions, the system will be perfected so that it can be deployed in space.
Cool. Science is power. There's no denying it. But we still need to find a way past all these goddamn magnets. Another door without a lock. Ugh. Where's the relay, Charles?
I don't see anything on the walls.
What the hell does Molotov have against Dr. Sechenov? Why'd he have to cook this commission up 2 days before the launch of Collective? Everything's ready.
Exactly, because everything is ready.
What do you mean? Are you trying to say that Molotov and his commission want to steal the brute succession ops labor 2 days before the launch?
Indeed. The malfunction Petrov caused is an excellent pretext for showing that Dr. Sechenov is incapable of overseeing Facility 3826, and by extension, the polymerization of the Soviet Union.
What's the boss got to do with it? This is all Petrov's fault. He's the one who made the robots turn the facility into a heap of corpses.
I'm afraid Comrade Molotov doesn't care how many victims there are, but neither does Comrade Sechenov.
What? What the fuck are you talking about, Glove? The boss is doing everything he can to fix this.
To be precise, Comrade Major, it's you doing everything you can to fix this, not Dr. Sechenov.
But he's the one who sent me here.
But why did he do that? Think about it logically. Comrade Sechenov and Molotov both have something to gain from preventing information about this terrible malfunction becoming known to the rest of the world.
Because no one would believe that a handful of traitors are responsible for the whole thing. Everybody would think that Soviet robots are dangerous.
Quite right. But what conclusion should we draw from this? Only that, hypothetically, Comrades Sechenov and Molotov should both have a vested interest in ending this nightmare as quickly as possible. Isn't that right?
Yeah. So what?
We're seeing a common, everyday power struggle. Instead of going to the government and having troops sent to Facility 3826 to destroy the hostile robots, arrest Petrov, or end this in some other way, Dr. Sechenov is doing everything he can to conceal the tragedy from everyone, including the government.
They can't send in the army. There are too many people. Somebody could leak intel to the enemy and then it's all over.
But only reliable men could be sent to the facility, such as the Argentum unit loyal to Sechenov. They could team up with combat robots and restore order in the blink of an eye. But I don't need to tell you about that, do I?
But that's, I mean, crispy critters. I don't get it. Why does it have to be so complicated?
Because Dr. Sechenov can't deploy troops or combat robots without the authorization of the Politburo. On the contrary, he's doing everything he can to make sure the government doesn't know what happened. Why do you think that is?
Because his enemies would take collective away from him? Now, when everything's built and ready to go, and any asshole with a badge could run it.
Quite right. It's all done. Just fix the malfunction and press a button. Geniuses, creators, and engineers have already done their jobs. All that's left to do is enjoy the fruits of their labor.
In other words, Comrade Molotov wants to put Dr. Sechenov in jail over what happened here so he can take over the facility himself?
To be exact, he wants to lead Collective.
But how can he? Everybody's going to be equal there.
Some will be more equal than others.
No, I know that high-ranking Communist Party members will have more authority in Collective than ordinary citizens, but that's fine. I mean, somebody's gotta make big decisions, right?
Is that so? Why, pray tell?
Well, first off, somebody has to be responsible for carrying them out. It's not like everyone can be responsible for everything. Everyone means no one. Someone's gotta take responsibility. The buck has to stop somewhere, right? And if the whole world did nothing but debate big decisions, no one would ever do anything. They'd spend all their time talking.
But what if you're wrong? You say that the entire world would never stop discussing important decisions. Collective is a collective mind.
So this little thing is the reason everything's all jammed up? This place is nuts.
You can ascend to the surface along with the mirror.
For once, you're right. I'd probably reach Nirvana before I could make it back down the way I came.
Have you infiltrated the VDMH yet, Comrade Major? The government's commission's condor has already left Moscow. They'll be here any minute now.
If the commission hasn't landed yet, that means there's still time. Just let me work in peace.
Shall I report to Dr. Sechenov that it is his requests that prevent you from working?
Yeah, you can report on how you ran away from those robots on the maglev platform instead of helping.
I am not a soldier, Comrade Major. I am doing intellectual, not menial labor. Smashing robots is your specialty.
The only labor you're doing is talking my ear off. Right now you're wasting my time and slowing down my mission. What?
Nothing.
That's what I thought. Thank you. dead bodies all over the place. Tereshkova's arm. What's that metal pervert doing with it?
That is a robot waiter.
Who's serving the people it killed? I'm gonna smash that fucking bot to bits.
The robot isn't currently hostile. We should be able to retrieve the arm without a fight.
Fuck that! There's no way I'm leaving that thing alive! How does it work?
Hold it up to my neurosensor contacts. Multi-key activated.
Now what?
Thank you for coming to my aid. Not having the key felt like I was missing a limb. One moment, please.
Did we fix her or break her?
The Tereshkova is a state-of-the-art model with a self-repairing system. A famous actress and cosmonaut contributed to its creation.
I don't give two wet farts.
Much better.
What the fuck are you babbling on about? What speech? You're prancing past piles of dead bodies, and there's blood everywhere.
My algorithms are glitching with horror. But my databases lack the verbal and visual tools required to express fear, horror, or other negative emotions. I was created to remain positive and optimistic, no matter what. The grotesque dissonance between my behavior and the gruesome surroundings grosses me out, but there's nothing I can do about it.
I see. I guess nobody expected this to happen. Okay, bot. Set the VDNH to drill mode.
Drill mode? This would lead to even greater aggression from passive and physical security systems. It will endanger you, and may lead to death of the surviving people, assuming there are still any left.
Exactly. If there are any left, this place is a fucking graveyard. Now follow my damn order, bot.
You have given me a most peculiar command. All people in this complex have been killed by robots, but you are unharmed. This arouses suspicion. Prove that you are a human. I will not follow the orders of a robot pretending to be one.
And how am I supposed to do that? Commit seppuku?
You must pass the Darwin test. This will prove that you are a human.
What the fuck? What test? How about I just rip your head off, huh?
Without her help, activating drill mode will take too much time.
I gladly confirm this information.
Fine, knock yourself out. Hit me with this damn Darwin test of yours. What am I supposed to do?
Prove that you are human, Pioneer Nechayev. Put three items on this pedestal that represent the three main values of a Soviet citizen. Art, labor, and life.
Crispy critters, now I gotta deal with another crazy-ass lock. Fuck, I'm a magnet for annoying bullshit.
So, what will it be, Major? Weapons or... What will it be, Major? What?
So... about this Darwin test.
Yes! I am always happy to help, Major.
Here you go. This is as alive as it gets around here.
Hear the spring's cheerful hymn. Be yourself, strive and earn. Life, I love you, and hope you love me in return.
Gosh, shut your face, you dumbass toaster!
I'm sorry. All this chaos is causing my emotional algorithms to malfunction.
Just watch your fingers. I'd rather not have to look for that multi-key again.
The hammer, tool of working men. The sickle, peasant's friend. The many-pointed star they praise, and with their lives defend.
Put something cheerful on, would you? It kind of feels like the end of the world right now.
Radio of the future! Astonishing music generated by the state-of-the-art quantum supercomputer, based on the preferences and tendencies of the modern performers. The theory of relativity claims these are the songs that the citizens of the future will be listening to.
But the citizens of today are already listening to it. Doesn't that mean this is going to be the music of the past once we actually get there? And nobody's going to write it 30 years from now because it already exists. The music of the future could change every second.
Well spotted! You have discovered a temporal paradox. How very observant you are. The music of the future shapes the music style in the present. However, the superposition of the observer and the information being perceived are located within a self-consistent loop. In layman's terms, we are always listening to the music of the future and determining what it is going to be like at the same time.
Oh, shit. If that's layman's terms, I'd hate to hear the complicated explanation. I'm getting a fucking headache here.
Pioneer Nechayev, you passed the Darwin test with flying colors. Tell me, what do you want to be when you grow up?
A cosmonaut.
What a splendid career choice. Well, I rather enjoy your attention, Major. Now, how can I help you?
Do you have a memory leak or something? I need to announce a drill and put the VDNH into drill mode.
Unfortunately, this is beyond my ability.
Are you yanking my fucking chain?
But I can provide you with a solution. You see, a single robot cannot engage the military drill mode. Such procedure requires the presence of two robots instead of one.
So where do I find another obnoxious metal dipshit?
Before that dreadful nightmare, the information hall was staffed by the two of us. But during the failure, the berserking robots took my partner, Claire, apart.
Did they scatter her all over the complex or something?
Precisely. How did you know, dear comrade?
Call it a hunch. Do I have to scour the entire VDNH for her parts?
Plug the administrative control drive into me, so I can tell you where the pieces of poor Claire currently are.
Well, that sure beats looking for him blind. So where's the administrative control drive? I'm running out of time.
Please follow me. This whole thing is just monstrous. The robots must have completely lost their minds. Would you look at this? Helping lumberjacks and first responders is such a noble goal. But you, how do you use the arms our creators have given you? Like a primitive animal, like a beast to crush and dismember. And this one, it just stands there buck naked, as if nothing were wrong. Have you no shame, robot? Publicly exposing your iridium compactor.
You do realize he didn't do it himself, right?
Oh my, that's a mess. And who, I wonder, will have to clean it up? I should dispatch the cleaners this instant. No, wait. It's the cleaners that did it. I'm so scatterbrained today. I envy you, humans. You can just pick up a razor and shave that horrible, monstrous mustache off. But this one, you're not even a machine, you nitwit. You're just an imitation, a caricature, a piece of lab equipment. Pardon the outburst. It's just that one of them used to try to... Well, let's change the subject. There's a wide range of the lab tech models. The ones in black turned out to be especially vicious. They've been using their harmless built-in range-finding laser to pick off humans from a distance. How did it ever come to this? Just so you know, the Black Lab Tech specialization is determined by the software package encoded within a specially constructed Kinetico Scholar Neurogel capsule. You can salvage this package from one of the defeated Black Lab Techs, provided its capsule is still in one piece.
What? I didn't understand a single thing you just said. You're an assistant, Tereshkova. Talk human.
Shocking! You have no sense of decency. I gather you've already met Nora, the monstrous repair vendor who's subjecting humans to unimaginable deadly torture. It pains my algorithms to have to send you into her bloody clutches, but we have no choice. She's the only mechanism capable of utilizing this capsule to upgrade your weapons.
Yeah. Move your ass, Tereshkova. We're in a hurry.
On my way, comrade. Who's a good boy? Who's the sweetest, silliest, chubbiest little boy? You little goof. You don't attack people even when you're in combat mode because you're such a little sweetie, isn't that right? Aren't you precious? Here we are, comrade. The administrative control drive should be at this booth. Please establish the connection. Only try to be gentle, Comrade Major. I have very delicate internals. Oh, what just snapped?
Relax, bot. That's my joints cracking. Does this look all right?
Administrator level rights granted successfully.
What now?
I'm opening the door to the atrium for you. Search each of the complex's floor and find my dear Claire. I'll be in touch over the radio. As soon as you reach a floor, I'll scan it for my poor friend's parts. Most of her is on the ground floor. Please put her back together again.
Wow, check this place out. It's like a palace. Talk about class. Let me just drink it all in. Okay, this is new. What's wrong with her head?
Welcome! Come closer! Be not afraid of my power.
What the Charles, is this another corpse?
I am Oracle. I am the All-Seer.
Got it. Talk about rotten luck. Charles, this one's completely lost her marbles.
What is this skepticism? Sergei Alexeyevich, you should be catching Viktor Petrov instead of doubting my greatness.
An interesting deviation. This woman is suffering from polymer overdose. This can happen when a human brain is connected to a large body of data. Obviously,
so she's part of the complex, with unrestricted access to everything? Huh. So, you're the Oracle, huh? Can you prove it?
I have no need to prove my power to you, mortal. But I guess I could indulge you for amusement's sake. What do you want? Shall I tell you about your missing past? Or the kind spirits that look after you and will silently weep forever? But what would be the point if you can't even see what's going on right under your nose?
That's quite a load of something. Let's make this simple. Open this door for me, would ya?
I will. I could open all doors, both in the past and the future. Behold, open up!
Oof, too much information can drive you crazy.
Indeed. I'd like to compliment you on your resourcefulness. That was clever. I guess you can think outside the box.
Yeah, I'm real proud of myself. She sure was a useful lady. How'd she find out about me and my mission at Vavilov if she never left the VDNH?
That is a trenchant observation, Comrade Major. And a very good question. One that I have no answer for.
Charles. What do the special neuroconnectors from Sechenov's team look like?
The special neuroconnectors have the Greek letter Gamma on them, and are shaped like bracelets. They are worn on the right arm.
Gamma? What happened to Beta? Or are those the fake connectors you told me about?
The fake connectors do in fact have the letter Beta on them, but the Beta connectors were real at first.
I don't get it.
The first experimental prototypes of the neuroconnectors with discretionary authority were called Beta connectors. Two of them, and Dr. Sechenov designed them to look like rings.
So,
what happened to him? After the necessary experiments were complete, Dr. Sechenov removed these rings from the list of special neuroconnectors. Enhanced gamma bodies shaped like bracelets were then made for the scientists, one for each member of his team.
There are only seven of those gamma connectors? For Vavilov, Rolyov, Chertov, Lebedev, Pavlov, Filimonenko, and Jelenay?
Indeed.
Thank you.
Scanning cycle. Module, limb, leg, left. Not found.
Just great. So where am I even supposed to look?
I swear on my cooling unit, these mustached perverts must have dragged her into the maintenance room.
I'm on my way. This place used to be really nice. Until everybody got killed.
It is a most tragic sight.
Hey, this is new.
You may need to apply spatial reasoning here.
There's no may about it. These locks of yours are...
You look so focused, honey. Are you thinking about me?
Buzz off, I'm working on my equipment.
I hope you're not thinking about that nasty doctor slut.
Who? What are you even talking about?
Why, Petrov's vulgar and graceless whore, of course.
You mean Dr. Filatova?
I do not care what her name is. She better keep away from you if she knows what's good for her.
Filatova will stand trial and be punished for aiding and abetting traitors to the motherland.
I knew she was a criminal, sugar. Let's train her up. Oh, it will be fun, I promise.
Shut up, you electric sheep.
What did you just say, handsome?
I said fuck off. You heard me just fine.
Oh, I love it when you are angry. Punish me.
Man, you are so fucked up. Hey, Charlie, why couldn't they just put regular, more reliable locks everywhere? Like with codes and shit?
I suspect it's because if they had, anyone who hacked the code would be able to open the locks without authorization.
Thank you.
green god!
Charles, I've never seen Dr. Sechenov wearing a bracelet before. Does his alpha connector look different?
Indeed it does. His device is unique, and its shape and location are one of Dr. Sechenov's deepest secrets.
So his alpha connector must be really well guarded. Who's watching it, Argentum?
Entrusting humans with the connector would be far too risky. It's guarded by Dr. Sechenov's personal bodyguards.
You mean the ballerina twins? The way they move, they're so graceful and elegant. They kind of remind me of something.
Is that so? What exactly, Comrade Major?
I don't know. Something good.
Service rooms, Major. One of my dear Claire's legs is most certainly there.
Yeah, The truth is out there, right?
I've never seen bots like these before.
This robot is very dangerous in melee combat.
Oh? So that's why I'm getting my ass kicked.
Charles, why did the boss take the real beta connectors out of commission? Were they defective?
Not entirely. Dr. Sechenov wasn't convinced that there was any need for discretionary authority within Collective.
So the boss wanted total equality, but Molotov's schemes changed his mind?
Perhaps so, Comrade Major.
What do you mean, perhaps?
Dr. Sechenov wanted equality for everyone. There can be no question of that. But consider this.
Here's your leg. Do yourself a pair thing. Cool tech.
Scanning cycle. Module, limb, arm, right, found. Location, level of floor. Transmission obstructed. Data incomplete.
What's the holdup? Why can't we locate the module this time?
I'm afraid I can't help you. There's some kind of interference on this floor. Possible sources of interference include electromagnetic shielding or the presence of a large, elongated object.
A large, elongated object? That sounds odd. Wow, there's a big honking thing in here. Lots of little fuckers. What am I supposed to do with this? What is this, a kid's game?
That is a puzzle key.
Nice. What's it for?
I believe it activates some sort of process.
Holy fuck, Charles! Is that the process I just activated? Where? Hey, what the hell are you doing, dammit? You metal son of a bitch! You scared the ever-living fuck out of me!
That was close!
Well, whatever. Got the arm. This looks like the right one. Let's go find the rest. whole beta connector idea was dead. They made the neural connectors with discretionary authority?
I'm afraid so. The power struggle in the Kremlin will never end. Party elite insisted on having power even within Collective.
Well, they're our government, right? We're the USSR.
Indeed, we are. But Collective was designed to be for everyone on Earth, and the USSR is not the only country.
We can't let capitalists and imperialists into Collective.
Why not? Collective was designed as a worldwide union for equal human beings, where robots will do everything for them. Everyone will have the same opportunity.
Capitalists won't like the sound of that.
Unfortunately, no one in power will see equality as an appealing prospect. So to avoid being crushed by the Kremlin, Dr. Sechenov programmed discretionary authority.
Okay, first arm's good.
Scanning cycle. Module. Limb. Arm. Left. Now. Location. Tablo floor.
Could you be a little more specific?
It's terrible. It's like something warm and sticky. Oh my. It is red polymer. Disgusting.
What does this even mean?
I am sorry, dear comrade. This is the only data I have available. I hope I managed to help you.
You sure did.
Please select the desired procedure. This whale's life was transferred into a polymer vessel thanks to the brilliance of Soviet scientists.
Aiding Dea.
Mimetic adaptation owes its existence to these amazing animals. Nowadays, polymers are made to adapt.
What's that crap in the canisters?
Be careful. That is a specimen called Plush, or Ivy. It is extremely dangerous.
Yeah, I've seen this crap before. And of course, the ripped-off arm is in there, too. Why couldn't it just be lying in a corner somewhere?
Hey.
polymer son of a bitch almost took me out. Let's hope another one of those freaks doesn't come crawling out of the next canister.
According to my data, the second canister is sealed properly.
Have you infiltrated the VDNH yet, Major? The government commission is almost here.
I'm inside, looking for a way to activate military drill mode. Things have been complicated.
Whoa! Hey! Why isn't anybody working? Are you asking for more?
Along with the real beta connectors.
Since Collective was originally planned without any discretionary authority, everyone in it was supposed to be equal.
Yeah, we already talked about that. Then why'd they need the beta connectors?
To secure Collective against unforeseen threats from individuals who might wish to control it.
That's impossible. Everybody's equal in Collective. Shit, the Alpha connector.
Indeed. Intruders or an opposition force among...
Here's your left arm. Go ahead, fix yourself up. Shit, it's dark here.
The National Complex is an underwater city that has been located at the bottom of Lake Mazur since
way out of here. Underground or something? Fuck me.
Where am I supposed to find the head?
You need to enter Icarus Hall. It is located on the second story of this venue.
So where's the entrance?
Unfortunately, I do not have this information. Everything's got mixed up after the malfunction.
No shit, Sherlock. Have you considered powering the balloon?
How is that supposed to help?
I don't know. It's just a suggestion.
Well, I guess it can't hurt to try. It's not like we've got a lot of other options. Tereshkova, where's the power room around here?
At the very top!
Fantastic. So we're cut off. Just what I always wanted.
So after Dr. Sechenov created the new gamma connectors, he destroyed the old beta connectors, right?
Officially, yes. But only the technology used to manufacture the beta connectors was destroyed. The pair of experimental rings were simply removed from all records and declared recycled.
Why go to all that trouble?
He didn't want to destroy the fruits of his painstaking labor. Dr. Sechenov simply kept them as souvenirs.
So where are they now?
They were somewhere in the Sechenov Science Center here in Facility 3826. But they apparently disappeared after the malfunction began.
Apparently.
You see what's going on here, don't you? No one knows anything for sure right now. The rings could be on a lab bench somewhere, or destroyed by rampaging robots.
There won't be any need for them in Collective. Dr. Sechenov and his scientists will be able to solve any problem without him.
I couldn't agree more.
So where's the very top? This is where the power comes from.
Are you sure?
Definitely.
How?
Because this place has my favorite thing in the whole fucking world. A relay.
Really? I thought you were more partial to canisters.
Oh, come on.
I'm dumb, endlessly stupid. I died because of my stupidity. If somebody buries me, put these words on my tombstone.
I wouldn't hold your breath. They'll probably just dump you already.
Why? Did many other people die?
Yeah, way too many.
Ooh, that's nice. I wouldn't want to...
Yeah, good times. Charles, you think Volatova was in cahoots with Petrov because of more than just love, right? What makes you so sure?
I should note that Larissa Volatova is an
authorization, Major Nietzsche. the world's fastest multi-purpose submersible vehicle. It can reach speeds of up to 78 kilometers per hour and is able to carry out civilian and military missions at depths down to 3,000 meters.
We've learned more about the ocean floor over the last few years than we had during the previous century.
I never thought about it before. I'm more interested in what's on the surface, you know?
That's a rather superficial perspective.
Let's see if this thing helps.
Did it?
Oh, yeah.
Right. What do we have here? Tereshkova, do you copy?
Yes, dear comrade. The communication is restored.
So, where's that head of yours?
My head is where it's...
So, what will it be, Major? Weapons or ability?
Like a maze for kids. This will be a cakewalk. Jumpy little thing, ain't ya? How do I rotate you, huh? Hey, I think I get it. Getting somewhere.
Do you have any idea what you're doing, Major?
Just a sec.
Is it really that difficult?
Crispy goddamn fucking critters!
Oh, for fuck... You know, Charles, I guess... Without saying anything... Yeah! Gotcha! Nice! Easy.
Upon a bed of shingle, legs raised like some old whore, far gone in passion, the burning, deadly, poison spreading eyes. Open its plunging, careless, cynic fashion, ballooned with evil gas. On this putrescence, the sun blazed in gold, cooking.
Yes, found the head. We gotta keep moving. Charles, any idea how much time we got left?
I cannot say for sure, but definitely not much.
Finally, I got all her parts. I feel no pain.
Have you activated military drill mode yet? Molotov's condor is about to land.
Everything's all set. I'm gonna go do it now.
Hurry, hurry! You only have a couple of minutes.
Right. Installing the head. All her body parts assembled. What now?
Self-repair procedure complete. I am ready for service.
Thank you, comrade. We will now initiate the launch sequence.
First launch code sequence generated. Please confirm that launch code sequence is matched.
Second launch code sequence generated. Launch code sequences match.
Initiating BDNH mode of operational change. New mode, military drill.
Whew, I think we made it. Thanks, ladies.
Thank you, dear comrade.
All in place. The complex immediately.
Please, Comrade Molotov, I beg you. It's not safe here.
So it's still dangerous. I was told everything was under control.
There was a minor issue, but Major Nechaev, forgive me, Agent P3, has already dealt with it.
What exactly did he deal with? There's blood all over the place.
That's not blood. It's paint.
Comrade Sechenov, you're playing a dangerous game here.
Greetings, Comrade Molotov. I don't follow you. What game?
You know what I'm talking about, Comrade Sechenov. Your local malfunction is actually a worldwide catastrophe. Your robots in combat mode. Countless human casualties. Need I go on?
Oh, please do. But first, I'd like to know how you obtained this information.
From Viktor Vasilievich Petrov, your engineer, an outstanding roboticist, an honored citizen of the Soviet Union.
That's what he used to be. Now he's prisoner number 230385, sentenced to community service at the Vavilov complex.
By your order, you are in direct violation of Soviet law. As a minister, the Minister of Industry, you know the consequences. Here is the Procurator General's decree. The upcoming launch of the Collective Neural Network will be cancelled, and you'll be the subject of a full-fledged investigation. Am I making myself clear, Comrade Sechenov?
Comrade Molotov, may I have a word with you in private?
Do you really think that's going to change anything? Fine. I'll meet you here in 15 minutes.
Mikhail, meet me at the landing pad.
Right away, sir. I'm sorry, sir.
Go ahead, go ahead. Aren't you in a hurry to see your master, Major? Stockhausen seems awfully eager. Is something wrong, Major? Major, I asked you a question.
Lock the door.
What's going on?